Ellie Bielan, member. This is a question for Mr. Canellas. You've previously stated that you have the Oregon Right to Life endorsement. However, you have not directly answered the question on a woman's right to choose. With that said, do you support the reversal of Roe v. Wade and Doe v. Bolton decisions so that elected legislative bodies may once again protect unborn children by limiting or prohibiting abortion?
The questioner is correct. I'm the only candidate here tonight that has the endorsement of the Oregon Right to Life. I have stated my position. It just depends on which forum I guess you would attend. Let me share with you some of the realities of this issue, this very divisive and sensitive issue. I'm running for Congress. I'm not running for the Supreme Court. I'm not even running for the presidency or the Senate. Those are the bodies that really affect this particular issue. In Congress, we stay focused on the funding. I would not support federal funding of abortion. I would not support any late-term abortion. I would support parental notification. These are the things associated with the bills that Congress deals with. And in fact, here's another reality of this very sensitive issue. If we, as voters, want to affect this issue and feel that it needs to be overturned, then not only do we need to hope that Roe v. Wade is overturned, but then we need to go down, and even before then, we should go down to Salem, because Oregon is on the books from 1969 passing a law that permits abortion in this state, and Roe v. Wade will not reverse that. So this is a state issue more than it's a congressional issue.
Con Lee, foreign member. I think most of the, most of the candidates would accept that the Tea Party protesters are out there because their perception is that important qualities of American citizenship are being lost, and their view that our government is eroding their rights as Americans. My question is, what would you do to address their concerns as a congressman?
First thing is listen. It's so frustrating as voters to feel disenfranchised. I can't tell you how many times people have come up to me almost daily when I'm out about the district meeting people who say to me, I wrote Congressman Wu, he never responded. Or I wrote Congressman Wu, he sends me a form letter. He's supposed to be our representative. I want to say something else about this particular district as it relates to the representative. I recognize in this room we have diverse opinions. We probably have very diverse party affiliation. I love that about Oregon. I love that because I could choose to live anywhere in this country because of the nature of my business. I have made a conscious decision with my wife to stay right here and raise our family. And so when I'm your congressman, I am not going to be like David Wu, who votes with Nancy Pelosi 98.6% of the time, because that's not representation, that's ideology. I will not be the Republican version of David Wu, because if I do, I am not performing my role as your representative. It doesn't mean we'll always agree on things, but it means that I have to truly represent people, and sometimes I'll make decisions that you'll disagree with, but as long as you know I'm doing it out of principle, using my best judgment, I think I will serve your interests.
Yes, my name is Diana Ward. This morning on the news, it could have been Fox News, it could have been CNN, they discussed something that happened. The government, under the TARP program, in bailing out Citibank, which apparently none of you people were for, the government sold back their shares to Citibank. Now, Citibank's already paid the money they got. The government's take on selling back those shares was $2.5 billion. Do you consider that a good investment or a bad investment?
To assume that we're against the bailout would be a wrong assumption. I'm against, because first of all, something had to be done. Our country was on the precipice. Why I was opposed to the bailout on principle was because when that bill was written, it was rushed through and there was very little accountability or transparency within that piece of legislation. As a result, we saw people who got us into the mess, who participated in getting us into the mess, we saw them getting billion-dollar bonuses. That is inherently unfair. I would also point out that whenever you consider an investment, you can look at the number that was reported as far as how much the government got back, but you also have to look at opportunity cost. How much could we have done to improve our economy had we taken those funds or freed up those funds for the free enterprise system, for small businesses? Now, John is an expert in mortgages. He's a mortgage broker, so I won't talk about the housing, but I'll tell you, in my business, we need money. We need the banks to free up money, and the banks have not freed up the money, and that's why American businesses are suffering. That's why your neighbors and mine are losing their jobs. That's why business owners are thinking about pulling the plug or doing something altogether, something else altogether. Mr. Johnson would like to comment on this question.
Mr. Robinson.